Hello everyone, welcome back to Hollow Knight. My quest to knock out my remaining trophies at the urging of my sons continues. In the previous video, I got the lay of the land a bit, collected some useful charms, got my fireball and my shade dash, and at this point there are still a lot of items that I need to buy from the various merchants that are open right now, so I need to gather geo as I explore and hopefully not get killed in any dicey areas that might cost me any money I happen to have pulled together along the way.
Thank you.
Completing the Hunter's Journal, which is the game's bestiary, is one of the trophies I'm still missing, and it's going to take a long time. As I mentioned in the first video, the save file from my original playthrough is gone, so I came back into this with nothing. So I'll have to work my way through all the various areas of the game, killing enemies however many times is necessary to fill out all the information for them in the bestiary. Some of the grubs that you rescue from these little glass enclosures are decoys. They're kind of like mimics in RPGs, so I keep waiting for one of these to go psycho and try and attack me after I free it. Thank you. We'll cheaters quick travel back to the bench.
Mas, tio!
Papa nada.
way. I can't get to Crystal Peaks just yet. Need the Firefly Lantern for this area. I missed this area last time. Nice easy pogo up to the grub there. Much easier to get to Salubrum with the dash. Let's see if I can buy anything else. And this is where I'm realizing that I'd forgotten that to buy extra charm notches, apart from having the necessary geo, you also have to have a specific number of charms unlocked. So I've got the money, but I don't have the charms to buy what I want. And the best part is that despite realizing this at this point in the playthrough, I'm gonna forget and come back here several other times throughout the playthrough to try and do the same thing because I keep forgetting about the charm count. And my sons think that's hilarious. Thank you. back here with ground pound to break this. This guy sells broken charms that you can use them as long as you want, but if they're equipped when you die, they break and then you have to buy them again. At a certain point later on, there's another NPC that you can turn these into, and for an absurd amount of money, they will repair them so that they don't break anymore. And in a little bit, I'll come back here with more geo just to buy the charms off of this NPC. I'm not actually going to use them, but they'll increase my charm count so I can buy more of the charm slots from Salubin.
Freedom Laya.
Thank you.
Gonna need Crystal Dash or the Wall Grab to get through this area, so I'll have to come back later. Sweet. All right, so we've got the wall grab now, so now I can grapple my way up walls. These guys, I remember being a pain if you come here too early. It's a triple boss fight. You fight one of them, and then when you beat that one, you fight the other two at the same time. So it can be kind of a headache, especially if you're not used to the patterns, which I'm not, and you're running a weaker sword, which I am. So I'm debating about giving it a shot right here, which is why you see me just kind of standing there, and then I'm like, no, never mind. Remembering that I can't get to this next area off of here without beating those three bosses, so let's try a different direction. Maybe I should fight them. No, never mind. In case you're wondering, the kids are asleep now, so I can't ask them for suggestions on where to go since they've just been through all of this stuff and I'm totally lost. Good times. Okay, so it hasn't been too long in-game, but it has been overnight in real life. And now I'm being told not to bother with opening an account with this lady because she's going to take all of my money and then just run off to some other area somewhere in the map and you have to find her in order to get your money back. Now, based on how this is going so far, my kid's going to be messing with me when they tell me this, but I have a vague recollection of that being accurate, so I'm just going to hold on to my money and hope I don't lose it somewhere. Lieutenant, that's my older son, says, don't kill the big ones, they explode. And what's the first thing that I do? Thank you.
吗？
Papa nada.
right here, this was the lieutenant's master chamber. That boss is easy, he tells me. No problem. You can take care of it while you're here. You don't have to come back. And then, while I'm busy dying to that same boss, he mentions that he had already upgraded his sword to level 3 before fighting him, and I'm still running a level 1 weapon, so it's going to be for days. And he and my younger son laugh while I die with the 1,000 Geo on the line. And at this point, I'm waging an internal battle between fatherly pride at their sinisterness and rage at that same fact. Okay, with my Geo secure, I can cheat travel back to the bench with my tail between my legs. I'll come back and deal with this guy later after I've upgraded a bit. So in the next video, I'll be on the hunt for that nail upgrade, at least the first one, and maybe the crystal dash, which will open up some new areas around the map. So we'll see how it goes. Thanks for watching.